Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to speak. I think many of my friends here know me as somebody who has crusaded research and development, tried to bring in a culture of R&D in the industry as well as academics, trying to bring the two together and see that we can take the product into the market. And I've had the opportunity and the pleasure of at least having three products in the market in this process, where the government, the academic institution and industries were linked and the products are there in the market. Now, having said so, the R&D pipeline, this is the R&D summit and the Destination India. How do we attract the outsiders to come and invest into R&D or set up R&D or support our R&D endeavor? This is something that we need very, very acutely. Actually, we need to make our presence felt in the globally. When you go in large international meetings, our presence is not that strong. So we need to build our own strength right here in India. This presentation that I'm going to make you is brief. Here it is infrastructure, capacity building, and some of the ongoing successes that I could make in this small SME that I have set up and which is working for the last 4.5 years. Now that's the Ara Healthcare Private Limited. We have focused in the development and production of newer generation of biological drugs. But as a commercial wing, we have set up Genex Diagnostic to support the R&D in some way. We have developed a large strength within to have models that can be utilized for generating the R&D pipelines. After all, if you look at R&D pipelines globally, there are over maybe 10,000. And we cannot, you know, total India's R&D pipeline, I still don't see, even in this two-day summit. So we need to create a very large pipeline, and some of these models would help bring those pipelines. And in the healthcare arena, molecular diagnostic or companion diagnostic for R&D of the biologicals or even for small molecules is going to be important. And therefore, we have developed this arrays of system. So if you put the two together, there is quite a bit of strength that we have created, bringing the expertise of earlier organization where I was, as well as in the present one I have tried to bring in. So what are we doing right now? We are working on recombinant molecules for out-licensing, because it's difficult for a small company to reach the market straight away. And we have some biosimilar molecules. So this is a pipeline of molecules. The other is the diagnostic services. Now, we have created a large facility. I think, being a scientist, I always thought that if I have the facility, I can do it. So therefore, if you can see, it's a fairly large facility that has been created. But these are more of smaller units. So if I count the achievements made so far, we have a product pipeline which are at different stages of development. Many of them have a novel approach, novel process, and high yield. So those are the criteria why we took. And you can see there are novel molecules, there are full-length antibodies, there are other biosimilars, and there is a nanotechnology. Now, if we look at the three novel molecules that we have, they have a very large market potential globally, and they need to go to another 3 to 4 years of development. Now, these were totally our own concept to whatever stage they are. So they are totally novel, their own ideas. We have filed patents for them, three patents. So of course we will file more families of patents, clusters of patents around them. But they need to go through this development, and we have been able to establish our diagnostic services, Delhi, NCR, and now Northern India we are touching. So in order to do all this, I had to gather the financial support. As you can see, I had a significant financial support from the government departments and of angel investors and Leap Start Trust, a VC group, as well as we ourselves have significantly contributed. We are, our investment together as my family together is around 61%. So I have myself significantly contributed into the growth of this company. So going forward, what do I want to do? Is that, here is what, I think I have heard a lot of stories of R&D successes. One of the difficulties in India is I have these 8 pipelines of molecules. I've been going around to see where can I outsource some of my activities. It's been very hard to find. It's really far and few between. If you want to see where you can go confidently, go enter for 3 months, come out with your project. No, there are hardly any places that you can do. Either they are too costly for SME, or they are, you know, they are not there. You don't get the guts to go and do it because money is very valuable for you. So what I want to set up is I want to expand this to a new location, which is a SCZ Life Sciences or Biotech Park, and create a center for excellence, not for myself, but many of the SMEs, the academic institutions wanting to bring their product to the market. So this is what this center I vision to have, is that it would have a R&D lab complexes for discovery, preclinical and product development, and a pilot scale research manufacturing complex and therapeutic clinic for clinical development. Now, when you have all of this under one roof, a molecule can go through, you can monitor it. Not one, not two, you can have multiple molecules going through. You can have family of patents. So, you know, the life story becomes different. It is, it's sort of, you can set up a culture there. And you do not spend time running around trying to look at, because, you know, in all of these lead selections, lead modification, optimization, development, is a very intensive, focused work. So this puts kind of a setup would be possibly first of its kind, and I have investors who are ready to support me on this. And so I hope that in next 2 years, when we have another summit, I don't know when, we can bring much more data, real presentable data, not talk of anything else, a pipeline of R&D molecules, R&D approach, R&D successes. One of the biggest key issue here, and there is also a lot of misconceived impression of the clinical trials, which is a very, very well described or worked out. It's a clinical discipline, it's a science, and there are these the somehow or other in the press and the activists have totally distorted this particular discipline, which has given a lot of, today cancer is manageable disease because of the clinical research. We have found cure for HIV because of the clinical research. And how can we deny it in India? So therefore, you know, we need large number of clinical development centers, otherwise your development work stops there, or you go out. How many people can go out and do a clinical trial in US, Europe to start with? After you phase 3, yes, you can go, because you know your drug is working. Before that, a drug which is developed here, it's very hard to go to Europe. The finances required is huge, and the entire approach is very different. The risk involved is extremely high. So therefore, I think there are these issues as pharma research is concerned. I really like that digital technology man who said that should change your culture. It's a $1 trillion business, and we should completely switch over from our conventional. Similarly, we need to completely change our conventional thinking to our drug, pharma, biotech research. I heard Renu Swarup speak. Yes, I think that is one of the approach, but we need to have a much larger approach, much more larger facilities to get into or really a significant product development and product into the market and get into the not the $1 billion, the $1 trillion market, which is possible with our own intellectual capabilities. Our youngsters are really good. I think if they get the opportunity, they can make, and this particular setup hopefully will provide a lot of opportunity, not only to our company but to new entrepreneurs who would like to enter into biotech research. Now, what is the comprehensive range of facility and services that we will be offering from that place? As you can see here, a lot of gap areas will be met. One of the difficulties is product development. I think a lot of academic institutions have no idea of product development. It's not their fault, it's not their forte. So a lot of problem is on establishing the therapeutic value of a new molecule, and that's where we'll be able to do. At the preclinical level, at the clinical level. Then the product development. Are you going to position it as an oral drug, an injectable drug, intravenous, whatever, subcutaneous? What's going to be your presentation? What will be the prescription like? It is going to be a daily or depending on. So in fact, you do establish the entire pharmacological profile of a new molecule in a center like this. And then you come up with a packaging development and a packaged new product, which can be registered and then marketed. And that's the range of service we would like to provide. And therefore, it's a complete range of development. And I get a feeling that we can at least handle 5 to 6 molecules a year. So in a 5 years' time, we should be able to handle a large number of products from this center. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Rama Mukherjee. Mm-hmm.